Hey everyone, welcome to New Hope. We're so glad you're connected with us online. I am Karina Ramos. Before we get started, don't forget to subscribe below and click that notification bell.
Hallelujah. Buenos días, iglesia.
Good morning, church.
Este es el día que hizo el Señor.
Today is the day that the Lord has created.
Día de alegría y de gozo.
Today is a day full of happiness and joy.
Dígalo otra vez, este es el día que hizo el Señor.
Let's repeat that again. Today is the day that the Lord has made.
Día de alegría y de gozo.
A day full of happiness and joy.
El primer domingo del mes de marzo.
Today is the first Sunday of the month of March.
El primer domingo de la jornada de Cuaresma.
The first Sunday of Lent.
El miércoles comenzamos una nueva etapa.
On Wednesday we started a new season.
Y Cuaresma no es religión.
And Lent is not religion.
La gente tiene mucho misterio acerca de la Cuaresma.
People have a lot of mystery around Lent.
La Cuaresma es espiritualidad.
But Lent means spiritually.
40 días revisando 40 nuestra espiritualidad.
Evaluating our spirituality.
40 días 40 cultivando
days.
Nuestra vida personal de relación con Dios.
Evaluating our personal relationship with God.
40 días creciendo en el Señor.
40 days growing in the Lord.
Y la iglesia ha escogido comenzar la Cuaresma.
And the church had decided to start Lent.
Estudiando el Evangelio de Marcos.
Studying the book of Mark.
Y no es un estudio fácil.
And it's not an easy study.
La serie se titula Marcos.
The name of this series is Mark.
Respondiendo preguntas críticas sobre la fe cristiana.
Answering critical questions about the Christian faith.
Vamos a hablar un poquito del Evangelio de Marcos, una introducción al texto.
So let's talk a little bit about the book of Mark. Give some introduction to the text.
Marcos, aunque el Evangelio no nombra su autor.
Even though in the book of Mark their author is not mentioned,
es unánime el testimonio de los padres de la iglesia primitiva.
We can with the testimony of the fathers of the founding church.
Que Marcos fue su autor.
That Mark was the author.
Marcos era el compañero del apóstol Pedro en misión.
And he was the person that was with apostle Peter in the mission.
Y como resultado era como un hijo espiritual del apóstol Pedro.
So as a result, he was like a spiritual son to the apostle Peter.
Él recibió de Pedro información de primera mano.
So he received first-hand information from the apostle Peter.
Sobre todos los eventos y enseñanzas del ministerio de Jesús.
About every event and every teaching that happened throughout the time of Jesus.
Y preservó esa información poniéndola por escrito.
And he preserved that information and writing it down.
Fue probablemente uno de los primeros libros escritos del Nuevo Testamento.
This is probably one of the first books that was written in the New Testament.
Entre el año 57 y 59 después de Cristo.
New Testament in between the year 57 and 59 AD.
Ahora, nos encontramos con Jesús en las páginas del Evangelio de Marcos.
So we found Jesus in the pages of the book of Mark.
Que a diferencia de Mateo, de Lucas y de Juan.
As a different difference from Matthew, Luke, and John.
Yes, good. Marcos actúa como un periodista.
Mark in this book is more like a journalist.
Que está tratando de reportar los hechos más importantes.
He's trying to report the most important events that happen.
Y responder las preguntas más críticas sobre la fe cristiana.
And answer those critical questions about the Christian faith.
Y la primera pregunta que vamos a responder hoy.
And the very first question that we're going to answer today.
Es, ¿cuál es la buena noticia de Jesús?
Is, what is that good news of Jesus?
Y sé que han oído hablar mucho de eso.
And I know we all have heard a lot about that.
Pero no quiero que te predispongas.
But I don't want you to be predisposed
to this. Abre tu mente y tu corazón.
Let's open our minds and
hoy
our hearts.
Vamos a repensar.
And let's open our thoughts.
¿Cuál es la buena noticia de Jesús?
What is that good news of Jesus?
¿Cuál es la buena noticia hoy?
What is that good news today?
Para un padre que tiene un hijo padeciendo de cáncer, la buena noticia sería el doctor diciendo, está libre.
For a parent that has a child that is suffering of cancer, that good news will be, yeah, your child is cancer free.
Para un matrimonio que ha estado a punto de llegar donde el abogado y firmar el divorcio, la buena noticia sería darse una segunda oportunidad.
For a marriage that is pretty close to go to the lawyer's office and sign up the divorce paperwork, the good news will be, let's give us another chance. Let's try again.
Para una familia que ha vivido conflictos, divisiones, pleitos, pérdidas, separaciones, sería, vamos a tener una hermosa reunión el día de Pascua.
For a family that have gone through conflicts, division, separation, lose, and losses, that good news will be, let's have a family reunion in Easter.
Después de ir al culto.
After going to church.
Yes, please. Please.
Por favor, por favor.
No seamos tan literalistas.
Let's not be that literal.
Para una iglesia, hoy, la buena noticia sería un gran avivamiento.
For the church today. Amen. For the church today, that good news will be a great revival. Amen.
Amen. Y para el mundo hoy, una buena noticia.
And for the world today, that good news will be.
Sería, se acabaron las guerras.
The war is over.
Ya no hay hambre.
There is no hunger.
No hay suicidios.
There is no suicides.
Homicidios.
There is no homicides.
Divisiones.
There is no division.
El reino de Dios está entre nosotros.
The kingdom of God is among us.
Dios gobierna con su reino.
The kingdom of God is here.
Dígame, aleluya.
Say amen. Say hallelujah.
Decimos, ay, a las noticias. Ay, 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 las noticias.
We're like, oh, my gosh, news, news.
Pues dígame, aleluya, ante la buena noticia.
But let's say amen. Let's say hallelujah. In between those bad news.
La joyful. La buena noticia de Jesús.
The good news of Jesus.
El Evangelio de Marcos nos ayudará en medio de este mundo lleno de malas noticias. Nosotros como iglesia y cuerpo de Cristo ser la mejor noticia que la gente desee escuchar.
The book of Mark will help us to be good news in between all these bad news that are going on, in between everything that seems to be wrong in this world. It's going to help us to be that good news of Jesus out there.
¿Te has preguntado cómo Jesús en un mundo en crisis en el primer siglo consiguió ser una buena noticia?
Have you ever asked yourself, how is that Jesus, being in a world that was in crisis, being in the first century, he was able to be good news?
El mundo de Jesús no era diferente al nuestro.
Because the world that Jesus was living in wasn't that different from the one that we are living in right now.
La única diferencia es que él era la buena noticia.
The only difference was that he was that good news.
Como iglesia podemos ser una buena noticia.
So how us as the Church of Christ can be that good news?
Quiero que abras tu Biblia en Marcos capítulo 1, los versos del 35 al 39.
I want you to go and open your Bibles on Mark chapter 1, verses 35 to 39.
Lo vamos a leer en inglés y en español porque quisiera que marcaran algunas frases claves en el texto.
We're going to read it in English and Spanish, and there are some important phrases in these verses that I want you to highlight. Before daybreak the next morning, Jesus got up and went out to an isolated place to pray. Later, Simon and the others went out to find him. When they found him, they said, "Everyone is looking for you." But Jesus replied, "We must go on to other towns as well, and I will preach to them too. That is why I came." So he traveled throughout the region of Galilee, preaching in the synagogues and casting out demons.
Ahora lea conmigo. Levantándose muy de mañana. Diga conmigo, muy de mañana. En inglés.
So repeat with me. Before daybreak, very early in the morning. Repeat that. Very early in the morning.
Very early in the morning. Wow. Muy temprano en la mañana.
Very early in the morning.
Se fue a un lugar desierto y Jesús oraba.
Jesus was praying.
Jesús oraba.
Jesus was praying.
Jesús oraba.
Jesus was praying.
Y lo buscó Simón y los que estaban con él y hallándole le dijeron, todos te buscan.
Everyone is looking for you.
Jesús oraba.
Jesus was praying.
Y todos le buscaban.
And everyone was looking for him.
Jesús oraba.
Jesus was praying.
Y todos le buscaban.
And everyone was looking for him.
Él le dijo, vámonos a los lugares vecinos. Dile al que está a tu lado, a los lugares vecinos.
Say to the person that is sitting beside you, we must go to the other towns.
Hacer una carne asada.
To do a cookout.
Una carne asada.
A cookout.
No creo que Marcos le gustara la carne asada. Quizás era vegan. Para que predique también allí, porque para esto he venido. Para esto he venido. Y predicaba en la sinagoga de ellos en toda Galilea. Y echaba fuera demonios.
And he was casting out demons.
Los demonios.
The demons.
Lo primero que te voy a decir, iglesia.
So the first thing that I'm going to talk to you about today, church.
Si quieres ser una buena noticia hoy.
If you want to be a good news today.
Tienes que levantarte temprano con Jesús y orar.
You need to wake up early in the morning and pray.
¿Cuántos se levantan temprano?
How many here wake up early in the morning?
Amén. ¿Y cuántos se levantan a orar?
And how many of you
wake up to pray?
To pray, not to go and
make coffee.
To pray.
No a revisar el teléfono.
Not to go and check your cell phone.
A orar.
To pray.
No a salir corriendo a hacer el día.
Not to go out running to start your day.
Levántese a orar.
Wake up early in the morning to pray.
Lo primero que el Hijo de Dios hizo fue apartarse para orar. Y la iglesia hoy no quiere orar.
The very first thing that Jesus did is that he went to a separated area to pray. But today's church doesn't want to pray.
Jesús se levantaba porque cuando él oraba, tenía una visión más clara de su mensaje, de su propósito y de su misión.
Jesus will go early and separate himself to pray because when he prayed, he had a clear vision of what his message, his purpose and his mission was.
Sin oración, no hay nada que anunciar.
Without prayer, there is nothing to announce.
Sin una vida de intimidad con Dios, nada tendrá expectación.
Without a life of intimacy with God, there is no expectation.
Nada cambiará.
Nothing is going to change.
No habrá vida, ni salvación, ni restauración, y mucho menos eternidad.
There is not going to be no life, no salvation, no restoration, no healing, and there is not going to be eternity.
Nada es igual cuando tú y yo nos levantamos de las rodillas.
Nothing is the same when you stand up after being on your knees.
¿Sabes cuál es mi lema de vida?
Do you know what is the motto that I live by?
Todo mi cuerpo es importante para Dios.
Everything in every part of my body is important to God.
Soy imagen de Dios.
I am the image of God.
Pero en las rodillas.
But in my knees.
Está el lugar de mi victoria.
That's where I win my battles.
En tus rodillas.
In my knees.
Está el lugar de tu victoria.
That's where your victory is.
Levántate de la mañana y ve a tus rodillas.
So wake up in the morning and go down on your knees.
Si muchas veces no, Dios no responde porque no vas a las rodillas.
If there are many times that you don't hear a answer from God, it's because you are not going down on your knees.
Ve a las rodillas, no a tu conciencia, ve a las rodillas.
Go down on your knees. Don't start thinking about it. Just go down on your knees.
Hechos 13:3 dice, entonces habiendo ayunado y orado, le impusieron las manos y se despidieron. Y si usted sigue leyendo el verso 4, el verso 5, el resultado de orar fue salir de allí a anunciar la buena noticia.
Acts 13:3 says, so after more fasting and prayer, the men laid their hands on them and sent them out their way. And if you keep reading on the verses 4 and so, you see that the result of praying was to go out and announce the good news.
Voy a decir algo que no están en mis notas del sermón.
So let me say something that are actually not in my notes for today.
Después que lo dije esta mañana en el primer servicio,
after I said this morning in the first service,
por la inquietud del Espíritu Santo,
because the Holy Spirit was moving me to say it,
yo dije, ay Señor, ¿qué dije?
I said, oh my God, what did I just say?
Pero cuando llegué a Logan Hall,
but when I made it to Logan Hall,
y vi aquel grupo de niños, jóvenes y adultos orando,
and I saw that group of kids, young adults and adults praying,
Dije lo que tenía que decir.
I said, okay, I said what I needed to say.
Iglesia, necesitamos orar.
Church, we need to pray.
Cuando usted entre por esa puerta,
when you come in through that door,
no entre a socializar.
Don't come to socialize.
¿Me escuchó? Usted no vino a un club social.
Do you hear me? You are not coming here
usted
to a social club.
Usted vino a la iglesia de Jesucristo.
You are at the church of God.
Póngase a orar.
You need to start praying.
Cuando usted sea el primero que se ponga a orar,
when you are the first person to start
todo
praying,
el que entre lo va a imitar.
Everybody else that's come in is going to start imitating you.
Después decimos,
and then we say,
no me gustó la adoración.
I didn't like the worship.
el mensaje de la pastora no me gustó.
I didn't like the message of the pastor Jamile.
Pero tú no te preparaste en oración para recibir lo que Dios tenía.
But you didn't prepare yourself in prayer to receive what God had for you today.
Tú recibes lo que te preparas para recibir.
You are going to receive what you prepare yourself to receive.
Decimos muchas veces, como dice la palabra, aprovechemos bien el tiempo porque los días son malos.
Many times we say, let's take good care of the time because the days that we're living in are bad times.
Estamos espantados con las guerras, los rumores de guerra.
And we're scared about the wars and all these comments about war happening.
La iglesia debería, como Jesús, apartarse a orar.
When the church should do like Jesus then, go and separate themselves to pray.
Llega a las 9 el domingo próximo.
So next Sunday, come here at 9
a.m. O a las 10. Y ocupe un lugar en su banco, aquí delante. Póngase a orar.
Take a place here and take that place to start praying.
Número uno.
So first thing.
Sin oración, no hay buena noticia.
Without prayer, there is not good news.
Número dos.
Second thing.
Jesús es la buena noticia para cada persona.
Jesus is the good news for everyone.
Todos le buscaban sin excepción de nadie.
Everyone was looking for him.
Le buscaban porque él representaba la buena noticia para su tiempo.
They were looking for him because he was the representation of good news for his time.
La gente estaba hastiada de escuchar malas noticias.
People were tired of listening about bad news.
Su mensaje era diferente.
His message was different.
Lucas 4:44 dice, cuando ya era de día salió y se fue a un lugar desierto, y aún allí la gente le buscaba, y llegando a donde estaban le detenían para que no se fuese de ellos, le procuraban.
On Luke 4:42 says, early the next morning Jesus went out to an isolated place. The crowds searched everywhere for him, and when they finally found him, they begged him not to leave them.
¿Para qué la gente te busca?
What are the people around you looking you for?
¿Para qué la gente se acerca a ti?
What are people trying to get close to you for?
¿Para una buena plática?
To have a good chat?
¿Para un pan con café?
To drink coffee and eat bread?
¿Para hablar de fútbol o de moda?
To talk about football, to talk about fashion?
¿O la gente se acerca a usted, a mí, porque quiere crecer espiritualmente, ser ministrado porque quiere lo que tú tienes de parte de Dios?
Or are people getting close to you, to me, because they want to have a different conversation, because they want to be ministered, because they want to have that you have, because they want to grow closer to God?
¿Estás bien sentado, iglesia?
Are you sitting good right now?
Voy a decirte otra cosa que no te va a gustar.
Let me tell you something else that you're not gonna like.
Pero que nos conviene escuchar.
But that it will be good for you to listen to.
La gente hoy no busca a Jesús porque muchos de los que decimos hoy ser iglesia, cuerpo de Cristo, las manos y los pies de Cristo, no somos una buena noticia.
People today do not seek Jesus because many of us, those who claim that are the church of Christ, those that say that they are the body of Christ, their hands, their feet, are not good news.
Jesús es la buena noticia para cada persona. Sé Jesús donde quiera que tú vayas.
Jesus is the good news for everyone. So be Jesus everywhere where you go.
Sé Jesús. Dile, Señor, quiero ser tú donde quiera que yo vaya.
Talk to the Lord. Lord, I want to be you anywhere I go.
Más de mí, más de ti y menos de mí.
More of you and less of me.
Y la tercera cosa.
The third thing.
Te dije primero, sin oración no hay buena noticia.
So first I said that without prayer there is not good news.
Segundo te dije, Jesús es la buena noticia para cada persona.
Second thing that I said is that Jesus is the good news for every person.
Atesora a Jesús para hacer esa buena noticia.
And you need to value Jesus to be that good news.
Y te voy a decir otra cosa, iglesia.
So let me tell you something else, church.
Jesús es una buena noticia, y dile al que está a tu lado, en movimiento.
Jesus is the good news, and said to that person that is sitting beside you, on the move.
Muévete.
Move.
Muévete.
Move.
La buena noticia no puede seguir cerrada entre las cuatro paredes de la iglesia.
Because the good news cannot be in between the four walls of the church.
La buena noticia hay que esparcirla.
Because the good news needs to be expanded.
La buena noticia es cuando salimos de aquí para allá afuera, ¿qué vamos a decir de Jesús?
The good news is when we get out of here and we go outside, what is that you're going to say about Jesus?
Esas palabras que decimos, ¿qué impacto pueden causar en otras personas?
Those words that we're saying, what impact those words can have in other people.
Pastora Vicky, queremos que la iglesia crezca.
Pastor Vicky, we want the church to grow.
Pastor Roberto, queremos que la iglesia crezca.
Pastor Roberto, we want the church to grow.
Isaías 9:3 dice,
and Isaiah 9:3 says,
el Señor multiplica a la gente y aumenta la alegría.
The Lord multiply the people and multiply the joy.
Pero la iglesia tiene que orar.
But the church needs to pray.
La iglesia tiene que anunciar la buena noticia de Jesús.
The church needs to be the one announcing the good news of Jesus.
La iglesia tiene que moverse en una misión evangelística.
And the church needs to move in an evangelical mission.
Hablar del evangelio de Jesucristo.
You need to talk about that
evangelio de Jesucristo.
The mission of Jesus Christ.
Hablamos mucho, donamos mucho, y Cristo.
We talk a lot and we donate a lot. And what about Christ?
Lleve las donaciones, pero ¿sabe qué? Hable de Jesucristo.
Go and take your donation, but you know what? Go there and talk about Jesus.
Si no es como 1 Corintios 13, como metal que resuena y címbalo que retiñe.
If not, you are like 1 Corinthians 13, that you are just a metal making noises.
Siéntate bien porque te voy a decir algo que no te va a gustar.
And get comfy there in your seat because I'm going to say something that you're not going to like.
No nos gusta hacer una buena noticia.
We do not like to be good news.
Dentro de la iglesia nos encanta predicar desde el púlpito.
Inside the church we all love to pray, to preach when we are up here at the pulpit.
Desde nuestras posiciones de liderazgo nos encanta brillar.
When we are on our leadership position, all of us like to shine.
Porque de una o de otra,
because one way or the other,
podemos brillar sin sudar.
We are able to shine without getting sweat.
Hablar sin demostrar.
And talk without showing.
Hacer sin sacrificar.
And do without sacrificing.
Para llevar la buena noticia.
To be able to take to others the good news.
Para ser una iglesia con una misión en movimiento.
To be able to be a church that has a mission on the move.
Tenemos que seguir el ejemplo de Jesús.
We need to follow the example of Jesus.
Fíjate en estos tres lugares.
So look at these three places.
En estas tres áreas donde Jesús desarrolló su misión.
These three areas where Jesus was able to develop his mission.
A esa nos está invitando hoy.
For that one that it's inviting us to.
Primero, ve a los lugares vecinos.
The first thing is to go to the neighboring places.
Ya te llevaste invitación de la iglesia y tocaste puerta por puerta de tu vecindario. ¿Dónde están tus vecinos hoy?
Did you already took the invitations for the church and knocked door by door and invited your neighbors? What are your neighbors here today?
Con tus vecinos crece la iglesia. Y crece el reino de Dios.
With your neighbors, the church will grow, and also the kingdom of God will grow.
Entonces, hoy por la tarde, buena tarea. Toca puerta por puerta de la casa de tus vecinos y háblale de Jesús.
So let me give you a good assignment for today. This afternoon, go and knock doors and talk to them about Jesus.
Salgamos de aquí en esta mañana a dar la buena noticia, porque para eso hemos venido, a recibirla. Para compartirla.
So let's get out of here this morning to share with others those good news, because that's the reason why we came here. We receive it, but we are going to take it to others.
Otro lugar de conflicto. No aplauda que todavía esto se pone bueno.
Don't start clapping because this is just getting started.
No aplauda hasta el final. No aplauda hasta el final.
Keep the clapping for the end. Keep it for the end.
Ay, dice que Jesús predicó en los lugares peligrosos.
And it says that Jesus went and he preached on those complicated places, those dangerous places.
Cuando llegué a la congregación hispana de Brandon,
when I came here to the Hispanic congregation in Brandon,
me sentí muy contenta por la misión en Cuba y en otros lugares.
I was very happy because of the mission in Cuba and all the other places.
Pero un día ya estaba cansado de escuchar los logros afuera.
But I was tired of listening of all the achievements outside.
Y le dije al grupo de estudio bíblico.
And I said to the Bible study group.
¿Ya fueron a Dover?
Did you already went to Dover?
Pero hubo una mujer que me hizo caso.
There was one woman that listened to me.
Ella no se hartaba solamente de ser una misionera internacional.
She wasn't just proud of being an international missionary.
Ella quiere tener también un escrito en el reino de los cielos que diga, pisé las calles de Dover y prediqué allí el evangelio.
She wanted to have that little card in heaven that said, I went to Dover. I walked through those streets.
Ese día Felicidad me tocó al final del culto y me dijo, quiero ir a Dover, pastor, usted me acompaña.
So that day, Felicidad went to me at the end of the service and she said, Pastora, I want to go to Dover. Do you want to go with me?
De ahí adelante, todos conocen la historia de Dover.
And from that point on, you all know the story about Dover.
Ser una buena noticia que adentro es muy bueno. ¿Cuántos han ido a Dover? Levante la mano. ¿Cuántos han ido a hacer misión a Dover? No a comer comida mexicana en Dover, sino ¿cuántos han ido a hacer misión en Dover?
If there is a good news in here, it's about Dover. How many of you have been at Dover? Not to go and eat Mexican food, no. How many of you have went to Dover to preach the word of God?
By the way, hacen buena comida.
By the way, they do make good food.
Y después de una gran evangelización, un buen pozole.
And after going out there and preach to everyone, it's really good to eat some good pozole.
Vamos a lugares peligrosos, iglesia.
Let's go to those complicated areas, church.
Vamos a lugares donde hay pandillas.
Let's go and talk to those places where there are gangs.
Vamos a lugares donde hay droga.
Let's go to those places where there's drugs.
Vamos a Waimama.
Let's go to Waimama.
Vamos a Gixington.
Let's go to Gixington.
Y quizás tú estás pensando en muchas zonas de alto riesgo a tu alrededor, pero no has ido.
And maybe right now you're thinking about many areas that are risky around you, but you haven't been there yet.
Jesús estaba predicando en Galilea de los gentiles. Ay.
Jesus decided to go to Galilee, the land of the Gentiles.
No en las plazas. Jesús había llegado a la sinagoga en Galilea de los gentiles.
And he decided to go to the synagogue in Galilee.
Nosotros empezamos en Dover en los campos de fresa.
When we started in Dover, we started to the strawberry fields.
Y dimos los primeros eventos al aire libre.
And we did the first events that we did them outside.
Pero un día le dije al Señor, tu pueblo es un pueblo de propiedad.
And one day I was talking to the Lord and I said, your people are people of property.
La semana pasada tuvimos un retiro de familia con 130 y tantas personas.
And last week we had a retreat for families that had over 130 people.
Y ya no le digo Dover.
And I do not call that place Dover anymore.
Le cambié el nombre.
I changed the name.
Dover es Cana, la tierra prometida.
And Dover is Canaan, the promised land.
¿Cuántos quieren ir a hacer misión a la tierra prometida?
So how many of you want to go and do mission in that promised land?
Y la tercera cosa que te voy a dejar como reto esta noche, esta mañana.
And the third thing that I'm gonna leave to you today as a challenge.
Hay que orar porque sin oración no hay victoria.
We need to pray because without prayer there is no victory.
Jesús es la buena noticia y no nuestras caridades.
The good news is Jesus and not all that charity that we can do.
La misión de Jesús está en movimiento.
The mission of Jesus is on the move.
Lugares vecinos.
Neighboring places.
Lugares complicados.
Complicated places.
Y es un ministerio de liberación.
And it's a ministry of liberation.
Lamentablemente la iglesia no quiere practicar un ministerio tan necesario.
Sadly, the church doesn't want to practice such an important ministry.
Si hoy escuchamos malas noticias.
If today we're listening to bad news.
Padres que se levantan contra hijos, hijos contra padres.
Parents that rise up against their children and children that rise up against their parents.
Son personas poseídas por demonios.
Those are people that are possessed by demons.
¿Y dónde está la iglesia orando por liberación?
And where is the church praying for liberation?
¿Será que la iglesia tiene miedo hoy a los demonios?
Is it that the church today is afraid of demons?
¿Será que los demonios fueron nada más del tiempo de Jesús?
Is it that the demons only happened in the time of Jesus?
¿O es que sabemos que el precio de un ministerio de liberación es fuerte?
Or is that we know that the price of having a ministry of liberation is very high?
Sin embargo, necesitamos la autoridad de Jesús.
But we do need that authority that comes from Jesus.
Para que la gente sea libre de esos demonios.
To have people be free from all those demons.
El pastor Roberto dice a veces.
Pastor Roberto says sometimes.
Muchas veces venimos a la iglesia.
Many times we come to church.
Y los demonios hacen fiesta en nuestra propia casa.
And there are demons partying at our own house.
Iglesia, levantémonos hoy por un ministerio de liberación.
So, church, let's rise up today for a ministry of liberation.
Quiero llamarle a tres cosas dando respuesta a cuál es la buena noticia.
So I want to call you out to three things, giving you an answer of what is that good news.
La buena noticia es que este es tiempo de orar, iglesia.
The good news is that this is the time to pray.
Esta es la oportunidad precisa para parecernos más a la buena noticia.
And this is the precise time to look a lot more like those good news.
Hoy es hora de poner la buena noticia en movimiento, en acción.
And now is the time to put those good news on the move, on action. Let's pray.
Señor, gracias por tu palabra. Ella nunca regresa vacía.
God, thank you for your word, that it never comes back empty.
Ella causa el efecto para el cual tú la envías.
And it caused the effect for the one for, that you send it for.
Ayúdanos a entender como iglesia.
Allow us to understand as the Church of Christ.
Que la única manera de ser una buena noticia.
That the only way that we can be good news.
Es orando.
Is praying.
Es hablando de Jesús.
Is talking about Jesus.
Es yendo a los lugares donde nadie quiere ir.
Is going to those places where anybody else wants to go to.
Que tu iglesia se sienta llamada.
That your church feels the calling.
Sacudida.
It feels shaken.
Por el poder de tu Espíritu Santo.
By the power of your Holy Spirit.
Porque tú has hablado.
Because you have talked.
Y en esta día de mesa del Señor.
And today at this communion Sunday.
Nos acerquemos a la comunión.
We come to take your communion.
Pidiéndole a Jesús.
Asking Jesus.
Ser esa buena noticia.
Be that good news.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén.
Amen.
Thanks for joining us. Did you know you can take us with you wherever you go? Search for New Hope Sunday Sermon Podcast in Apple Podcasts or wherever you get your podcasts from. To learn more about New Hope, please visit us at findnewhope.com. God bless.